Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Today I'm talking PDO threads. With results, how deep should they be placed? Does it make a difference? Does it change the outcome? Let's have a quick video today on PDO threads getting great results and what the depth of placement has to do. And if you're not getting great results, could that be the difference? So remember, if you like these videos, subscribe below and don't forget to click the bell, and that way you'll be notified on all the new videos. We're talking PDO threads today. There's many other topics, and remember, there's a whole playlist. So if you're interested in threads, if you're thinking about getting a thread lift, if you're a provider of threads, you can click on my playlist. I don't know, maybe there's 25 or 35 videos there all about threads and different properties of them. Today, we're talking about depth. Over in Asia last month, we had a great conversation and debate about different thread depths. Let's talk about, in general, the cheek and the barb threads. One of the reasons I'm doing this video is I got so many questions through Instagram and here on YouTube about people saying about threads, hey, maybe I didn't get the results I wanted. I had fabulous results. Or I saw some results, but almost nothing for what I paid for. So you'll see all of those factors in there, and they might ask me, why is the case? Is it too deep? Is it too superficial? Let's start with my all-favorite smooth and twist threads. These threads should be placed more superficial. And that's the bottom line. You don't want to see the thread. But if you put it too deep in the fat layer, it's not going to stimulate the collagen, it's not going to give that glow, and it's not going to give the effect that you want. You have to mesh it, not in the fat layer, not intradermal, because again, and it's possible to get them intradermal because a lot of the smooth, a lot of the twists are still loaded on needles. And to be frank, what do I like better? I kind of like the needles better to getting my depth, especially if you're using a 2.5 inch, a longer smooth or twist, because the needle becomes more flexible and you're always navigating that depth. If you're just throwing those threads in and they're going deeper and you're not taking time to consider the plane, I just don't think you're going to see the result. One of the areas with smooth threads that I was shocked and surprised about the result is the cheek. And I would put smooth threads in along the cheek to get a little lift at the edge of the mouth to make the skin more robust so I could go to barbs. But what I saw was so many people coming back. Everything I do is two sessions, 6 weeks apart, everything. So same with the threads. So we do the two sessions, superficial. And then I'd say, oh, then I'll go to the barb. The patients know the threads. Then they're used to getting them. If they had a problem with the barb thread or they felt it poke like you can, they're much more apt to take that side effect or what goes along with everything that does with the barbed threads. It's more robust to do in stride. But what I saw was we got a lifting. We had nice skin. We had glow. And I didn't ever have to go to the barbed thread, which is great. The less you need to do, the better it is for your provider because the less aggressive we have to be and the more cost effective it is for you. So many people look at how much is it? How much do they charge? I'm coming in based on price. If you go to a good clinic where, and there are many of them, where they care about the patient and they want to get your result, they don't want to do big procedures on you. These are ongoing treatments that people get over time, and threads are no different. So smooth threads, I want this to be a quicker video, are more superficial. Let's go to the new barb and molded thread. The depth of these is very important. You're going to be deeper, and a lot of people ask the opening of the cannula, where do I like it, facing up or down? If I take a 21 gauge barb, a traditional barb type thread, I typically have the cannula port facing up. I can be more superficial with this thread. What are we grabbing? Osteocutaneous ligaments, more than likely. You can grab the dermis a little bit, but I think that's much more temporary lift. So we're a little deeper with barb threads. If we go to the new molded threads, and I'll put a link up here to the video of the new molded infinity thread. And like I said, go to the playlist and watch them all. Pick what might be pertinent to you. But don't miss that video because the molded threads, have changed everything I do with threads because of the results we get with them, the ease of use, and the amount of lift. But when we go to that molded thread, it's harder to correct or unzip it. Why? I'm talking about puckering and side effects now. It's one of the most common annoying side effects. It's not a common side effect, but common enough that it's the most annoying. And here, a link to a video up here on how to deal with that. So I have videos on how do you deal with the puckering. Well, one of the things is unzipping that thread. And it's a lot harder to unzip one of those molded threads because of the amount of pull they have. They don't have little barbs, but they have little molds that attach to the skin, kind of molded blocks of barbs, if you will. And it doesn't dissolve as fast. So if you had a side effect with a barb thread because you went too superficial, that's likely to resolve quicker than the molded threads. Interesting threads, what's coming up? A lot of people want to know. See, this is meant to be a short video. It's becoming long already. But I love to talk about it. One of the cool things they saw over in Asia was the temporary thread with a more permanent outside to it. So that's interesting too. And today we're talking mainly PDO. The same would apply for PCL threads and PLLA. What's the longevity of those real quick? PDO will go away quicker, followed by PLLA. They're kind of close, but the PLLA probably lasts a little longer. PCL is even longer. And you can go to my videos to see, I have a video on how many threads do you need? How long does it last? So that's an answer. The superficial threads, more superficial, is with the smooth and the twist, deeper with the barbed threads, and then the molded threads are even going to be a little deeper. Of course, we don't want to be too deep. There are structures. There are certainly nerves and vessels, of course, as we know, but also the parotid duct. There's a lot of anatomy as you start going deeper. Be very careful. A lot of these are blunt, so that's helpful. But don't go into the mouth or through the mouth. You don't want to be that deep. Remember, osteocutaneous ligaments and those ligaments from the dermis to the inside of the mouth are really what we're grabbing. So that helps. This does not apply to the eye. I'm going to do a whole other video on that. Probably that debate we had was maybe an hour or two. So you can see, and these are people that do thousands of procedures of threads a year. And we debated that long about the eye. Are you deep to the soup? Are you superficial? The eye is a different animal for everything, even fillers. As you see from my PRF under eye, my filler videos of the under eye, most things that we talk about are very different from the neck down, the jawline, the cheeks. The eye is thin skin like the neck. So what I'm talking about with depths, I'm going to do a whole nother video on the eye. So it doesn't apply to the depth. Are we deep in the soup? Are we superficial? And what are we trying to accomplish with the eye? A whole nother video. Thanks for joining me here. Subscribe below. Go to Instagram because we debate these things over there. And give us your opinion. This is a forum for education. It's not a teaching forum, but it's to give ideas and share ideas. And I'm giving you my ideas. What are yours? What's your experience been with these? And remember, the thread is the thread. The result is the science, the knowledge, and the education of your provider. And there are many great providers around the United States, Canada, and around the world. So do your homework, watch my video on finding a provider, and find someone that can see you over time. Local providers are always best. Have a great day. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.